I remember distinctly when I first sat on the console, I just knew that this will be how surgery will be performed. But there was tremendous skepticism early on.
There are definitely misconceptions about robotic surgery. People ask me a lot, oh, you must have played a million video games as a kid. Surgery with Da Vinci, it's not just like video games.
Doing robotic surgery, it is the most immersive experience where you feel that you're inside the patient's body.
When I sit down at the surgeon console, I really feel like I'm just an extension of the instruments. So in 90 minutes, I make an enormous impact on someone's life.
I want to be able to grow old and be a grandmother, but I really didn't see that in my future. I really was concerned. This is the one thing that has completely changed my life.
I find the operating room to be my haven. It is one of the places where there is the most activity, but there is also a strange kind of peace and quiet and rhythm. I am the chief of the section of esophageal and foregut surgery at NYU Langone Health, and there are so many spaces where we work in where the precision really matters. And I knew that there were limitations to the existing platform for minimally invasive surgery. That's where I really thought, right about 2011, that I wanted to really embrace robotic surgery. I felt that this will allow me to do surgery better. This will allow me to do more complicated surgery and still keep it minimally invasive. But there was a lot of pushback and access issues for general surgeons. When I first got into it, there was no community, but surgeons now have a lot of role models around them or people they look up to within the department who are doing a lot of robotic surgery. And this generation is just maybe innately more comfortable with this kind of computer interface between them and patients.
In open surgery, we would always sew towards ourselves to close this, so I mimic that in robotic surgery. I look at the people that learned this in the beginning, and I have no idea how they stuck with it without all the resources we have now. I was first introduced to robotics during my residency and fellowship. Once I went through the training and became more familiar with it, I 100% bought in.
I had the surgery in February 2021, and this was July of 2021.
I always struggled with weight, even as a child. By the time I reached 50, I was approximately 220 pounds, and my blood sugar was increasing. I was at a point where I had to make choices for myself, or I was gonna not live a long, healthy life. As a nurse, I had seen several patients have gastric bypass. I worked in the ER, and I saw a lot of complications, and it really discouraged me. I thought that would be something I would never consider doing. To go in and to do a procedure that's going to change me for the rest of my life was scary. But as my weight increased and I started having a lot more comorbidities, I started thinking this might be the one thing that will work. Thankfully, one of our new providers at the time, Amanda Peischer, changed everything for me.
I commonly joke that I'm the most emotional bariatric surgeon on the planet, but it's really just because I love my job and I love my patients so much. And seeing them do well after is the best feeling in the world.
Gastric sleeve surgery was something I kind of felt like I would never consider doing myself, but there have been so many advances, especially with robotic surgery, and people having a lot less complications and people being able to go home the same day. So in February of 2021, I had the gastric bypass procedure done. Robotic surgery is one of the main reasons why I felt completely comfortable with it.
In my own clinical experience, robotic surgery has been the safest option that I can offer to my patients. My patients that I was operating on using the Da Vinci robot had way shorter lengths of hospital stays, had way fewer complications. So about 3 years ago, I transitioned my practice to 100% robotics.
I was discharged the next morning at, I believe, 7:30. I was ready to go. I got home, I had no pain. I took Tylenol once or twice and was back to work less than 2 weeks later, feeling 100%.
we are turning the skeptics into believers. We're really beginning to see how we can shrink our operative times and have great outcomes while using robotics.
There's definitely growing interest in robotic-assisted surgery. I think it has been easier for me to transition to robotics than the first adopters years ago. One of the reasons why I feel so strongly about mentoring, I want to be able to give back and help others the way that the mentors above me helped me.
The shared sense of purpose of the robotic surgery community now is something that is so refreshing. We all believe in the merits of this, so I'm very excited to see what the future holds.
We're helping people live for their families and their friends. I just can't think of any other surgery which has a bigger impact than that.